I found something. Something very bad has happened in the harbor. Thank you. I'll yield to none.
Thank you.
nice.
Gazes up at something looming high above. Her face is a mask of terror. She jumps in front of the echoed impression of her since-fled child. A huge, unseen force suddenly slams her into the ground, flattening her form into a puddle. The spirit of a magister mimes something, unaware of his own demise. He seems to be securing a ship's gangway onto the side of the dock. You snap to attention as she descends from the Lord Dread. Dallas herself. If only your parents were still alive to see this, they'd be so proud. A flicker of movement catches your eye. Something alongside the ship, beside the water's surface, a writhing mass of huge tentacles. You reach. The spirit of a dwarf cowers behind some rubble. One of her legs is suddenly yanked backwards, and she's hauled upwards into the air. The spirit of a paladin lurks near some cargo at the edge of the dock. You do your best to remain inconspicuous, observing the scene from behind some barrels and crates stacked near the water. The Lord Dread looms ahead of you. Dallas herself descends the gangway, Fraidman following at a distance. You need to report this to Lord Ken. The traitors are here. It's only when you try to sneak away that you realize something has curled itself around your ankle. A powerful tentacle. It pulls.
Ship is the Lord Dread.
Or what's left of the Lord Dread.
The spirit of a magister trembles before you, his eyes glazed with fear. You stand with your unit in silence as Dallas barks a motivating speech. You don't watch the hammer, but the Vredeman creature that trails her. You search the darkness underneath his hood for a clue. Who is this man, this sorcerer? How is it that he stands at Dallas's side and is not imprisoned in Fort Joy, where... And suddenly, within the cloak's shadows, there is a light, a flash of teeth, a wicked grin. Suddenly, you realize he's... Everything goes dark. You see nothing. You know nothing.
Bloody freezing! We can't stay here!
I don't fancy having my bones frozen in place down here. I can feel my joints freezing up already.
We need to get back to warmth. It's too cold here.
They're frozen.
I can hardly breathe. It's too cold. Bloody freezing! We can't stay here!
I don't fancy having my bones frozen in place down here. I can feel my joints freezing up already.
We need to get back to warmth. It's too cold.
Praise the divine!
I can hardly breathe. It's too cold.
Oh, darling, you're all right.
I don't fancy having my bones frozen in place down.
The spirit of a woman throws phantom rocks in a desperate attempt to stave off unseen threats.
I found something.
The girl's spine suddenly arches back at an unnatural angle. A squeal of distress morphs into a deep, throaty chuckle. She straightens and looks at you. Her eyes are black.
She is ours. You will not speak to her. You cannot help her.
The girl squeezes her eyes shut and bows her head. Her own voice emerges, quavering with stress.
I can't do it. I can feel the sunlight and the...
The laugh rises once more, and the girl lifts her head. Her gleeful eyes remain pitch black.
Fool! She is ours. Any strength is ours.
Her eyes clear for just a moment, showing a brief glimpse of the child within. Then the blackness fills them once again, and the demon hisses at you.
You give her hope. Good. It will make her spirit all the more delicious for us when she breaks. The child's purity cannot protect her. She cannot resist us. She is nothing. She doesn't even have a name. Fool, you're wasting your time.
A flicker of recognition crosses the girl's face before the demon regains control.
She whimpers for the creature. You twist the knife in well. Her name is Lost. Nothing. Soon she will be nothing.
A harsh, rattling laugh.
You put too much faith in the girl's spirit. She cannot resist us.
The girl's eyes clear for a moment, but then are swallowed by darkness once more.
Pathetic! Truly pathetic! Perhaps her true name would have helped, perhaps not. Now get away from us! Your efforts grow.
Thank you. Lord Ahu has returned. Thank the gods. Thank you. We owe you a great debt. I haven't seen the likes of her the whole time I've been stationed here. And...
God Woken, you return. My dear, we all have questions. Sometimes we may even get answers. In my time, I've worn many hats, many of them pointed. I've been a scholar, an engineer of sorts, a protector of towns and villages, a thief, a lover. For one, those were the days. But through it all, I've been what you might know as a wizard. All these long years, I have worked to maintain balance in the world. Lately, that has seen me at the service of Lucian. But this is just one way to tell my tale. There are many versions of Ahu through the ages. My body, or bodies as it happens, age. It may sound stupid, given the world in which we find ourselves, but I strive for balance and a realm in which all creatures can feel safe and free of terror. Hence, my alliance with Lucian. I have lowered my aspirations somewhat in recent centuries, I admit. Now, I'd settle for the world staying out of the void. Amazing how your priorities change. I knew Lucian would defend Rivellon from oblivion. I thought he would be equal to the task and easily succeed. It seems I may have been wrong.
I'm not picky, so long as the arrow flies straight.
A visitor. Tell me, do you like puppets?
The toy seller nods and smiles.
Wonderful. Here, take a look at this.
The puppet springs to life.
Impressive, no? There's a lot of craftsmanship in that small package. Quite a lot. Now, what can I do for you? I haven't had many callers of late, what with all the fuss and hubbub that's been going on outside. Source, what else? Each and every one of my darlings has a little bit of magic in them. It turns a mere toy into a friend. I'm on good terms with the Divine Order. They know what my work entails. They've even had use for me in the past. I have nothing to fear from them. Oh, no, not at all. I use only the smallest sprinkle of sauce in my work. I'd hardly think a Voidwoken would set its sights on me and my darlings. I love my work. I love the possibilities of it all. The idea of engineering something to perfection. But one aspect always fails me. People.
He throws an adoring glance to one of the puppets.
My darlings aren't like that. They are pure and beautiful. They don't make mistakes. And they don't question my desires. I don't need others anymore. I have something better. Held captive by Kem? Are you certain? Then I was right to sequester myself here with my puppets. Trusting people is a folly. But it seems that you are to enter the tomb of the divine. And I am to help you get there. So be it. In order to pass the first chamber, you'll need an amulet that's charged with source.
5 souls worth, to be precise. Here, take this amulet and fill it with sauce. When you've done that, return to me and I'll tell you what must be done next.
You must wear the amulet as you consume sauce. The excess power will be siphoned into it until it is full.
Good luck. You may need it.
Amulet is storing the source. The amulet can't hold anymore.
The puppet looks at you with what almost amounts to curiosity. A faint...
Greetings. I trust that the item I gave you is having the desired effect.
Fully charged, you say? That would mean that 5 souls have been... Actually, I'd rather not dwell on exactly how you charged the device. On to the next matter.
You'll need the Scroll of Atonement. It's locked in my desk on the 2nd floor. The password is Giora. When you have both the charged amulet and the scroll, go to the Path of Blood. On the left side of the chamber, on a pillar near Lucian's statue, you should see a hidden mechanism. It will clear the way. Good luck. You may need it. Daddy's going to fix you right up.
Keeper's permission granted. You may pass, friend, and...
The puppet's words choke off. It spasms and flares with sauce. Then it is still once more, and a different voice emerges from within.
You have hampered me long enough. This place will be your tomb, the only one you shall enter.
The desk is locked tight. Instead of a keyhole, there's a gilded inlay that bears an engraving. It was all for you. Beneath this sits a framed square of blank parchment. You take a nearby quill and dip it into an inkwell. Then you poise its tip over the framed square of parchment. The ink is absorbed into the parchment until it vanishes. Somewhere within the desk, a mechanism unlocks with a click.
I believe I've told you all that you required. Was there something else?
What? There must be some mistake. They're just toys now. They wouldn't hurt a fly, unless I wanted them to. I'll look into the matter. A misunderstanding, I'm sure.
I'm not picky, so long as the arrow flies straight.
Nature provides.
Hunters, I've got the wires.
Hey, me first!
And she seemed so confident.
I pledge my life.
I'd say we're close to Lucian's body.
There, a switch.
There's a curious-looking panel discreetly nestled upon the wall. Upon it is a lone button. There's a slot in the center of the button. It looks like something should be placed in it. The amulet fits the slot perfectly. The mechanisms around it begin to glow with source. The button slowly sinks into the wall, as if pushed by an invisible hand. The source fades from the amulet, consumed by the inner mechanisms of the button. Gears turn behind the ancient walls, almost like they're acknowledging the words you spoke. A nearby hatch in the floor unseals itself.
recognize the approaching child. He is hardly a picture of innocence. His cheeks aren't rosy, but sallow. His smile isn't curious, but crooked.
Surprise! You left a little boy to rot in a prison cage, and yet I made it here. What do you say to that, eh? What do you say to that? I'm not a little boy. I'm not. I mean, I can see why you'd think I am.
His voice changes, becomes deeper, rougher, older.
Really, I'm not. Say hello to your mistake.
A razor smile unfolds upon his lips, but his eyes are gone. The light in them has turned black. Any time he may have had as a sane and functional human is well and truly over.
Yes, my Lord Lucien, I'm coming. I'll free you. I'll protect you. I'm coming, my lord. I'm coming, Lucien. I'm coming. I'm coming right after I...
Well, that's one problem solved. Now on to the next.
Thank you. She seemed so confident.
I literally saw the
book. Something closed the door. There, a switch.
There, a switch.
There's a curious-looking panel discreet. There's a slot in the center. The amulet fits the slot perfectly. The mechanisms around it, the buttons slowly sink. The sword gears, a nearby hatch in the floor.
Looking at this, I'd say we're close to Lucian's body.
You recognize the approaching child. He is...
Surprise! You left a little boy to rot in a prison.
I'm not a little boy.
His voice changes.
Really?
A razor smile.
Yes.
Well, that's one problem solved. Now on to the next.
Thank you.
The statue reaches toward the sky, as though preparing to take flight. The bottom drops out from within you. She lifts you up, up, up.
Too heavy.
No sign of Lucian's body. Has Dallas beaten us here?
The blessed altar seems to want to be touched. The altar seems to respond. Beyond it, something creaks, as if the pipework was moving. The sound comes from beyond the altar, but also echoes and gurgles behind. A blessed stone altar. The cool stone seen in the space beyond the altar, the pipework shifts. In the pit beyond, things move once more, as if returning to their original position. Then the mechanism rests. A blessed stone altar. In the pit beyond, things move. A blessed stone altar. The cool stone seems to bend. The altar seems to respond. Beyond. A blessed stone altar. The cool stone seems to beg to be touched. In the space beyond the altar, the altar seems to respond. Beyond, a blessed stone altar. The cool stone in the space beyond the altar.
The altar seems to respond. Beyond it, something creaks. A blessed stone altar. In the pit beyond, things... A blessed stone altar. The cool stone seems to beg to be touched. In the space beyond... The altar seems to respond. A blessed stone altar. In the space beyond the altar,
In the space beyond the altar, the pipe... The altar seems to... Peering through the iron grating, you can see how it connects to the strange pipework. A blessed stone altar, in the space beyond. Thank you. A blessed stone altar. The altar seems to respond.